Hey everybody, welcome to the most controversial dog YouTube channel on the net.
Yeah, I said it. You're controversial, lady. You're controversial.
If you didn't know, yesterday we created a title for our video that was a little bit clickbait, and everyone literally freaked out. Everyone had a problem with it. We heard you. We understand. We changed the title, and we're never gonna make that mistake again. You gotta understand. YouTube is kind of like a learning process. Whenever you're doing YouTube, you never know exactly how to do it, because it's kind of like brand new. There's no book on how to do the YouTubes. And while yesterday Britney Spears did jump out of the back of the Tacoma at the very end of the video, we understand most of our audience was expecting one of the dogs to jump out of the vehicle while it was moving. I understand that. I get it. No. Neither of the dogs were in danger while we were in the truck ride. We were only going like 15 miles an hour around my neighborhood. We were barely even moving. I was in the back with them holding a leash that they were attached to. They had about a 2-inch span to move around, unless I deemed it so. So nothing was dangerous about yesterday's video, and I'm very, very sorry that it was titled in a way that confused people and tricked them into thinking it was something different. That's my bad. I'm on top of it. Make sure it'll never happen again.
They're like, we're sorry. We didn't mean it. We didn't mean to make you guys upset.
So, enough of the jibber jabber. What are we talking about on today's episode? Why do you look like a plethiosaurus? Why are you like swimming around like you're a turtle? Are you a sea turtle?
He's like, maybe.
I can be whatever I want if I dream it.
He's a good boy. He's a good boy. Yeah, you good.
Today we're gonna be talking about how often you should be doing things with your husky. How often you should be taking them out for a walk. How often you should be brushing their teeth. How often you should be feeding them. How often should you be doing all of these different things. So come with us on another episode of 60 Formula where we find out how often you should be doing all the necessary things with your Siberian Huskaroni pizza. Are you ready, sweetheart? She's like, yeah. You got a cute nose, you got a cute nose, you got some pretty, pretty, pretty eyes. Can you speak? I shall go, Bowie. Can you speak? One more time. Speak. Yeah, good boy. All right, now let's get right into it, right, buddy? Now let's talk food. A lot of people ask me, how many times a day should I be feeding my Siberian Husky? Well, it depends on how old your Husky is. So let's crush this first question real quick. If you got a puppy, you should be feeding them 3 times a day, 1 cup per feeding session. If you have an adult Husky and the older they get, you should be switching it to 2 times a day or 1 a day and feeding them up to 3 cups in 1 feeding session. But just remember, if you're gonna feed them 2 times a day when they're an adult, you should probably cut that in half. So if you're gonna feed them 3.5 cups a day when they're an adult, cut it to 1.25 cups per times a day. That's only if you are feeding them 2 times a day. If you feed them 1 a day, you can feed them in the morning or at night, and we definitely recommend mixing dry kibble with wet food, especially if you don't feel like going into the raw diet. Next up, how many times a day should you walk your Siberian Husky? It all depends on your schedule, how much time you have, and how big your house is. Do you have a backyard with a fence? Are they able to walk around and hang out in the backyard without your supervision? If so, you probably don't have to take them on a whole bunch of walks. Going outside and running around in the backyard, especially if it's big enough, will often be good enough for a Siberian Husky. But if you live in a little apartment, you're gonna have to take them on walks. Now, we definitely suggest doing it about 2 or 3 times a day if they never get to go outside or have a backyard. And we recommend walking them in the early morning hours or the hours after the sun has gone down. This is when it's the least hottest outside, so you don't have to worry about the pavement being so hot or the sun beaming down on your Siberian Husky. So like we said, it depends on your lifestyle. If you have a backyard, you may only get away with walking them 1 a day. But if you don't, you live in a small apartment, you're probably looking at 3 or 4 walks in 1 day. Can I get a paw? Good girl, can I have the paw? Other paw?
Yeah, you a pro, dude.
That deserves a good old treat. Can you speak? Yeah, that's good.
Oh my goodness, it is raining so hard outside.
What is your analysis of the rain? All right, a lot of people ask me. She's like, I don't know, dude. I want to go out and play in it. That's my analysis. All right, the next thing people ask is, how often should you brush those teethers in your puppy's mouth? Now, this is different with everyone. Some people brush their dog's teeth every single day after every single meal. Some people brush their dog's teeth only a couple times a week, and some people only brush their dog's teeth a couple times a month. What we recommend is somewhere in between all of everything we just said. I definitely recommend doing it a couple times a week. Don't be excessive about it. You
don't have to brush your husky's teeth every single day. They're doggos. Chewing bones and chewing hard toys is gonna clean a lot of that plaque off anyways. So it's really not that necessary, in my opinion, to wash your dog's teeth more than a couple times a week.
Ooh, look, it's a finger brush. It's a finger brush. What do you think of that?
He's like, I don't know what that is, dude.
You wanna see a finger brush? You wanna see a finger brush? Yeah, what is it?
Look, Roo's like, dude, I wanna hang out, but Gila keeps sniffing my booty. What do I do?
So typically every other day I will brush down Gila. What I'll do is I'll just like let a day go by and then I'll brush her. This is just something therapeutic for both the dogs, so I like doing it a lot. You don't have to do it every other day. I kind of think maybe that's a little excessive. Definitely don't do that with the Furminator. Just get a simple brush like this. This is like a two-sided brush, has soft bristles and hard bristles, and just give them a couple little comb downs every other day.
Yeah, that feels good. Gotta keep that tail looking all delicioso.
And that leads us into our final question. How often do your Siberian Huskies blow their coat? Basically, people ask, how often do they shed? First of all, Siberian Huskies shed like every single day. What do you think I have this army of vacuum robots over here for? But every few months, when the weather changes, I'd say every 3 to 4 months, Siberian Huskies will blow their coat. And that means a lot of their fur will come out in large amounts. Roo's like, absolutely disgusting. I never lose that much fur. If I did, I'd be gross. So yeah, every 3 months, your Siberian Husky is going to poof. Some people say it's only 2 times a year, but if you live in hotter climates, especially like in Florida where it gets really, really humid, your Siberian Husky will blow their coat more often. Isn't that right, lady? Isn't that right? Yeah, you got a pretty face. So that's about it. Those are all your questions about how often you should be doing these things with your Siberian Husky. If you guys have any questions, let us know in the comments down below. We'll be sure to answer them for you ASAPizzle. If you guys are having fun with the episode, be sure to hit that like button, hit subscribe so you never miss another episode. If you have a brand new Siberian Husky puppy or a brand new pet that you would like to show Gila or Britney Spears, be sure to visit our Instagram and our Facebook, both linked down below. And we'll see you next time with another episode of Guess What? Yep, whatever we make.
What, you wanna be in the outro? All right, fine. You can do it this time.